Hey, good morning. I'm so happy to be back with you all. I missed you yesterday, but it was Mariano's birthday. So being the good mom that I am, I wanted to really take time and just be present. And so we had a full day yesterday, and it was such a blessing. But I'm happy to be back with you all. Today, we're going to be discussing 2 Corinthians chapter 7. During prayer this morning, the Lord led me there, and it is such a timely word. We've been talking about that, prophets and messengers and the correction that they have to offer. Many times, it's not well received in the moment, but we know that it often produces a sorrowful, godly repentance, and that's what's important. As messengers of God, when God gives you a word, it's so important that you are obedient. Oftentimes, it will not be well received in that moment, and a lot of times people misconstrue messengers of God because they think, oh, that they're harsh, that they don't have compassion, that they always have a word that is critical. But it's that when the Lord asks us to speak and to say and bring a message, it is to produce repentance. So no correction feels good at the time. And I can tell you that it's not easy to deliver a word of correction. No one wants to be seen as the person that always has something corrective to say. But it's important that you allow the Holy Spirit to work through you, because you have to remember that that word is going to sink down and convict that person. And although they may not admit it at that time, eventually the Holy Spirit will do the work. So it's not for you to blast somebody. It's not for you to say, aha. It's not for you to condemn someone. You deliver the message that the Lord has placed on your heart out of obedience. If it's received at that moment, wonderful. But if it is not, your only job was to share that message. Then you can wipe your hands clean, because I can tell you personally, I don't want the blood of another person on my hand. So if the Holy Spirit asks me to share something, no matter how uncomfortable it is, I know He will give me the boldness and the courage to say what I need to say and to also leave it there, okay? So that's exactly what Paul had to do. In 2 Corinthians 7, he had to deliver a tough word to the Corinthian people. And they didn't like it. They didn't want to hear it. And Paul said he felt some kind of way about having to deliver it, but he knew he had to be bold and courageous in what the Lord had placed on his heart to share with those people. And although it was a tough word that they didn't receive immediately, the Bible says that it did cause them to examine their walk, and it caused them to repent. And that is the whole goal of a corrective word, is that you examine yourself when you get that word. You pray about it. Take it to the Lord. You don't have to trust that, okay, this person's brought me a word and I don't know about it. Take it to God. He is so faithful to convict you and to say, yeah, that's you all day, you know? And then you can do the work to repent and to confess your sins and make it right. But what you don't want to do is be like so many people who get that corrective word. They don't want to hear it. They turn a deaf ear and they say, oh, that is not me, and the Lord is not pleased, because you are letting pride take root in you instead of allowing God to do His perfect work. And pride, we know God hates. None of us are perfect. We all have sin. We all have error. And the Bible says that He chastens those that He loves. So the fact that I have to get a word of correction, I know my Father loves me. Just like your earthly father, like my husband has to discipline my boys when they are off track. It's done in love, not because that He just wants to just, you know, harm them, but He wants to see them go in the right direction. And, you know, David said in the Psalms, one of the Psalms, you know, the correction of the righteous is like oil on my head. I'll take it all day, because I know that it's coming from a good place and it's going to lead to my salvation, okay? I don't want to keep walking in the wrong way and then the Lord's giving me a message and I don't have ears to hear. I want to be quickened to His word, sensitive to His word, so that I can be corrected. And that's what I love about King David. He always had a heart to receive the word from the Lord, to be corrected and to turn from his ways. He was not like, you know, Saul, who when Samuel brought the correction to him, he was like, who are you talking about? That's not me. I didn't mean it that way. I was doing just fine. I'm all good with God. We me and God cool. And Samuel's like, I got a word from the Lord from you, boy. And it ain't all good. Because Saul didn't have the humility to receive that word. It led to his demise, y'all. Never despise the word of the Lord because you don't like the vessel that it's coming from, or you don't understand the word that is being said. Examine yourself, humble yourself to the word of the Lord. Take it to God, but don't just be like some people that right off the top you give them word. That's not me. Me and God good. I'm good in this area. Really? Did you even pray about it? Be very careful. Be very careful in your response to correction. Okay? So again, Paul had to be bold. He wrote this letter. The Corinthians didn't like it, but they thought about it. They self-examined themselves. And look, this is what the word of God says. It says, "For even if I made you sorry with my letter, I do not regret it." Paul like, listen, I don't regret it because look, "For I perceive that the same epistle made you sorry. You didn't like me at the time when I delivered that word. You thought I was harsh. You thought I was mean. You're like, who is this guy? But I don't regret it. I'll be the bad guy because guess what? It led to sorrowful repentance." He says, "Now I rejoice, not that you were made sorry. I didn't want to make you mad, but that your sorrow led to repentance. For you were made sorry in a godly manner." See, Paul was, you know, correcting him with the word, them with the word. It wasn't that he was just giving them worldly wisdom. He was correcting them with the word of God. And so he says, you know, "Although you didn't like me at the time, thank God it led to a repentance. So I don't regret it." And you can't regret it either. When God gives you a word of correction, you must share it boldly because prayerfully it's going to lead to repentance and you all can rejoice together. Okay, when they examine themselves and come around. It says, "For you were made sorry in a godly manner that you might suffer loss from us in nothing." He didn't want them to suffer loss in nothing. He wanted them to grow in their relationship with Christ. That's true friendship, y'all. That is true leadership. He had to give them correction because he didn't want them to lose out in anything. That's the kind of friends you want in your life. You don't want people that will allow you to walk in sin and pat you on the back and say, "God is full of grace. You good? God knows your heart, girl." Yeah, and it's incredibly wicked and you need to repent. You need friends and people in your life that will say to you, "You're on the wrong path. Thus says the Lord," and correct you, okay? You don't need people that will pat you on the back all the way to hell. And that's what we got. We got a lot of worldly friendships, and we don't have a lot of godly ones. Pray for godly friendships, and pray that you're able to receive them in your life. It says, "What diligence it produced in you, what clearing of yourselves, what indignation, what fear, what vehement desire, what zeal." Man, what vindication. It produced good things in them. The fact that Paul had to correct these people, it brought more desire for the Lord. It brought them closer to the Lord. They were praying more. They had more zeal for the Lord than they ever had. It inspired them to get back on the right path. Do you have people like that in your life? When they give you correction, it inspires you. Like, "I'm going to get closer to God. I'm going to read my word more. I'm going to listen to the Holy Spirit. I want to walk in unison with the Spirit." Do you have people in your life where they inspire you to walk closer to God, even if it has to come from a correction? The Bible says, "Faithful are the wounds of a friend, but the kisses of an enemy are deadly." You want to have wounds that are faithful, that are going to lead to repentance, that are going to help your friend, help your loved ones walk closer to the Lord. You don't want to be a friend that gives you kisses of an enemy. You know what that is? Flattery. They flatter people all the time, right to hell. They never offer a word of correction because they don't want to be seen as the bad guy, right? But when the Lord gives you the boldness to give a message, it's important that you be obedient, no matter if at that moment you have to be that tough guy, as Paul was in 2 Corinthians chapter 7, when he has to deliver that epistle. And they are like, no, you didn't. Mm-mm-mm. but it worked to their benefit. It produced, it says, diligence. It produced a sorrow, you know, zeal, passion in their lives for God again. So, you know, go back, read 2 Corinthians 7. It is powerful to understand. Remember that God chastens those he loves. He chastens us. We all on this walk are going to be corrected in one way or the other. And we have to be ready to receive that, because we know that it's going to work together for our good and that it brings us to salvation. We are all being cleansed, sanctified from glory to glory. Guys, so your correction will come. But when it comes, be like David. Oh, how I love the correction of the righteous. And it is like oil on my head. So I hope this word blessed you today. You all have a wonderful day. Enjoy this beautiful day. Make the best of it. Be intentional with your walk with God. Make time to sit in his presence, to sing his praises, and to worship him. I thank you for listening to me. I thank you for your time. And I pray that the Lord blesses you and that his face shines upon you and that you succeed in all that you put your hands to. Take care, y'all. Have a great day.